I believe that many of the cases that we handle at this firm involving on-the-job injuries, we do our best not only to represent the family that was the victim of that incident, but also that our work affect changes to improve safety so that other people in the future don't have to go through those same circumstances. Oftentimes, our litigation will lead to design changes to make it products safer, and also sometimes to regulatory changes, where NHTSA or OSHA will make a change in their regulations to make issues or the environment safer so that employees don't have to go through what someone else went through involving either a serious injury or a death. A lot of the cases that come to the firm don't come directly from the client themselves. They originally went to a very good lawyer in their area, Mr. David Martin. Mr. Martin is not a part of liability attorney. He does not have the resources and the expertise required to handle such a claim. So he recognized that it was in his and his client's best interest to get that claim to our law firm because we have the expertise and the resources to take on such a claim. So anytime we have a case that comes to us from another attorney, that family or that individual becomes our client, and we work with that attorney to do what we can to assist that family. Daikin is a company in North Alabama that deals with the manufacturing and processing of chemicals to be used for further production in the industry. So they may make refrigerant or different types of chemicals. They are governed by rules and regulations we're dealing with, understanding what the materials are, making sure that if you are exposed, you have the proper PPE or personal protective equipment, and making sure that you follow the rules and regulations that are in place whenever you might be exposed to a dangerous substance or chemical, which includes proper ventilation, protective equipment, and also monitoring to make sure that your levels don't reach a dangerous amount. As this litigation proceeds and we start to get into what we call discovery, we will obtain documents and information so that we can answer our client's question as to what happened to our loved one and why. Combined with that, whenever OSHA finishes their investigation, we'll be privy to that report, and that will also shed light on what occurred, what happened, and more importantly, what can be done to prevent this from happening again in the future. The citations are just the beginning of the process. So now Daikin has hired an attorney, and that attorney will represent Daikin in the federal litigation with OSHA. And more likely than not, some of those citations will be either withdrawn or the fines will be reduced. The current fine at $233,000 or in that neighborhood is not enough, but I know, given my experience, that fine will be further reduced. More likely than not, it'll be business as usual for Daikin. Again, because OSHA has the right to go in and investigate, but they don't have the authority or the ability to really affect an employer like Daikin enough that will change future behavior. Keep in mind, for my client, this is not the first time someone has been killed at Daikin. The same thing happened in 2019, where two other people died under the same or similar circumstances. And here we are again, even after that investigation. So history tells us that more likely than not, history will repeat itself